I'm excited to take the team to the location where I had my first face-to-face encounter with a Sasquatch that led to the creation of the BFRO and so much that's happened in Bigfoot research since then.
Wow.
The trees are so much bigger, but it's the same tank. That's the tank that was there. And here I was, laying down, tried to hide behind the berm because I figured they'd walk out of there, come through there and walk past here. But it comes through the trees and it comes out right over here and it just walks out through this curtain of leaves and just stands right there and starts growling.
Well, I know that we've all heard this story before, but now that we're here, take us back 20 years in time, run us through the night.
I had put classified ads in all the little local rural newspapers around and got a bunch of calls from witnesses. And one of them was named Brian Jones. I and the local guy Brian had gotten out here just after dark. I sent Brian off to perch in a position about 100 feet away from me so he could have a different view down a different stretch of the road. We hunkered down there and waited for hours. Then at about 2:30 a.m., Brian says he's hearing voices and footsteps coming down the gravel path. And that's when I hear big footsteps coming just inside the tree line to my right. Finally, this big, tall, dark, hairy thing steps out from the brush and starts growling. I start talking to the thing, like, it's okay, we're leaving. And I'm like, my God, because I had waited years to have that kind of an encounter and I just had it. And I'm just like, I don't care what any other doubters say after that. They don't know.
Yeah, I remember when I had my sighting, I didn't sleep hardly for 3 days, just I was so jazzed. Being here with Matt just totally reminds me when I had my first, you know, full-on visual encounter where you knew without a shadow of a doubt they were real. And it never mattered again the rest of your life what anyone thought of you, said, joked, whatever. You know they're real, you know you're right, and it just can obsess you, make you consumed with filming them, proving they're real, showing the world.
Have you ever done a size thing? Have you ever put somebody like Bobo in the spot to gauge what you saw?
No, I didn't.
Well, this is gonna be quite the honor doing Buddy Baker's recreation.
Yeah, you gotta go right back in here.
When we brought Matt back to the exact location, he, like other witnesses, showed visible emotion. I mean, look at him. His voice is elevating. He's extremely animating. He's sweating profusely. This guy is clearly showing us some raw emotion at this point.
So I'm in the right spot, Matt?
Wow. Put your hand up, man. It was higher than that, even higher than that, maybe another 6 inches up. That's about where it was, and it was just so much bigger than you.
So it was well over 8 foot, then 6 inches above my fingertips.
I thought it was closer because it was so big, but it was right there. That's where the edge was. But again, there was a curtain of growth right there, so it walked out just enough so that I could see its whole body. I thought it was maybe only about that tall, but it was much bigger than that.
It was 8.5+ feet, it looks like.
It had to be.
One of the things that we learned about the Sasquatch Matt saw that Matt didn't even know himself was the size of this thing. He'd always described it as about 7.5 feet tall, but what he realized is that it was bigger than that. It was just a little further away than he thought.
Well, do you still think this is a viable spot for a night investigation 20 years later?
Oh yeah, there were so many sightings along that creek and then down at Berlin Lake. There's squatches all through this area. I'll say in the woods, I'm back!
And this time it's personal.
That's right.